up, y'all? How y'all doing today?
Your papa had it bousted.
Will, leave me alone, okay? Leave me alone.
Your papa had bousted.
All right, I in the mood for you today.
Your papa had bousted.
Anyway, you are...
Big Just Be Sexy.
I am Nikita.
And welcome back to Will and Keena.
Yes.
Yeah! Sarah.
Oh, okay.
Margarine. I'm saying words like my grandma would say.
Oh, okay.
That's why I said pop-headed bousted.
Right, right.
Pop-headed.
I have heard of that.
What is pop-headed? You pop-headed bousted? Pop-headed bousted.
Anyway, what were we reacting to?
You better go in there and eat that Sarah. Broly radiates Black Air Force Energy by CJ the Champ. Anyways, y'all, here we go.
But then look at this right here. It's a 4-on-1. Now, you see, any other day, you see a 4-on-1, somebody about to get their ass jumped.
Okay.
But now, Broly hit him with that Uno reverse card, bruh. He said, y'all about to get jumped by me and me alone, bitch.
Oh, my soul. I remember watching that movie and witnessing the utter menace. That ain't even a word, is it? Ministry?
I don't even remember the word.
The utter menace that freaking. See, I'm trying to see.
Join this council.
Some words I can't pronounce. They
see, he's a menace.
My God, if he makes,
but
it, it's a bigger
menace to society.
No, I'm saying like three by himself. Is the act of being a menace called ministry?
Legendary ministry. 9,000 himself.
But. That's what it's going to be, ministry.
Now,
I don't remember seeing the utter ministry in that movie.
Like, the original Broly movie, like, he had the stupidest backstory I've ever heard of.
Yeah, if I have to put up one more time, sit still.
I like
that
they
fixed
it.
We're not here to hear any of that.
Shut up, stupid.
No, hey.
We're here to see this big ass, tall ass, 7-Eleven ass motherfucker host some niggas. So y'all already know I got the evidence on deck. And it is time to see if this man is worthy to be sat at the round table of Black Air Force activity. So without further ado, Exhibit A.
Exhibit A.
This man beat the hell out of 4 Super Saiyans and a Namek at the same damn time. I'll tell y'all this. This might be one of
well, the yeah, because Goku's Vegeta too. History.
Like, this man literally ran everybody's fade. Like, they couldn't even jump him, bruh. Look how he just dodges all this shit with no effort, giving zero fucks in the process.
Oh, my.
Hey, but, yo, I ain't gonna lie, though. At the beginning of the movie, I didn't think he was gonna be all that. I mean, when you first see the dude in his base form, I mean, come on, y'all. Just look at his ass, bruh. With this long pencil-ass neck.
What's your power level?
The inbred shirt out of Central Alabama.
Mine's pretty big.
This man looks high as a kite, bruh. Like, this nigga look like he in his own world at the moment. So, when I was a kid, I was like, all right, this gonna be some easy work for my boy Goku. Nobody could be Goku,
be easy work,
right?
Oh.
It's okay. It's okay. He just getting warmed up.
Look, it looked like he just getting warmed up at this point.
Getting the hell beat out of him is what's happening.
Oh. God, God damn it, stop! Yeah, this man was running everybody's fade with no effort, bruh. But you wanna know what Broly's greatest speed is in my eyes? This man made Vegeta, a member of the round table of Black Air Force activity, a bitch.
Oh my soul.
Like, yo, my nigga didn't even wanna fight him, bruh. He made Vegeta.
He said he's legendary.
Vegeta shit bricks. Bro, oh my God. Had this nigga on his knees and everything, bruh.
He said he is the essence of a Super Saiyan.
What's up, nigga? With your ba-ba-ba-ba-ba? I'm loving it. Ass hairline. I'm gonna revoke your ass from this goddamn council. Damn, you lucky this movie ain't canon, nigga. Shit, I was gonna have to put up a poll to revoke your Black Air Force energy license, bruh. This is goddamn unacceptable. But you know what? I'll let it slide just this once. But if I catch you doing some bitch shit like this ever again, your ass is getting revoked, nigga. But anyways, I feel bad for these little green people, bruh. This man Broly just murked they planet for no reason. I mean, this is how this basically went down, bruh. Roll the clip. Oh, look at the little green niggas trying to do some rebellious ass shit. I got a question for y'all. Is that your planet right there? Yeah, why? Nigga, fuck your planet!
Oh!
I remember that.
Oh, shit, what that nigga doing?
He was on Black Air Force energy from the jump. Because why did he have to blow up the planet?
Just kidding.
He did it. The flight lab.
This vicious ass WWE style clothesline, bro. Like, this dude literally picked Trunks' ass up off the ground with his arm and slammed his ass in the wall, bro. Hey, I ain't gonna lie, though. This man Broly might have
been... That man throwing everything. Hands, feet,
history, dog.
Elbows.
I mean, just listen to what this man says real quick.
Kakarot
knees.
How much do you love your son?
Shins.
No, he just asked if he loved his son.
How much do he love his son?
How much do you love your son? Hell no, bruh. That's how you know you're dealing with some of them psychopath ass niggas, dog. Look at him just eat this knee to the jaw, bruh. Dude just ate that shit for breakfast, bruh. Then, oh, poor Gohan. Oh my god. He came out the wall.
The fear. The fear in his eyes is crazy.
On the wall. Like, bruh, chill. The dude's only 11. Yo, this man Broly said these hands are ready E for everyone. My
oh my god.
And it just comes out of nowhere than just double clotheslines, so, bro. Oh my god. And then he does it again, bro. You know who Broly reminds me of? That one character in a fighting game that just has that one broken ass move that you can just spam over and over and over again. Like, bro, we all know we all have that one friend. That one friend that always plays the OP ass character and just spams that shit. Like, they can be absolute dog water at the game. Like, literal doo-doo cheeks. But once they catch your ass slipping once, it's over, bro.
Oh, my.
You're done. Like, this is literally Broly, bro. He is the embodiment of side B spam. Like, he only needs one move, bro. Stick out your damn arms and just move forward. And your spam was just battering Goku, bro. But you know what? I give Goku props, bro. At least he was still fighting him.
Yeah.
Like, yo, bitch ass.
He said he was
tired. It sucks when your favorite character gets bitched out like this. But then look at this right here. It's a 4-on-1. Now you see any other day you see a 4-on-1, somebody about to get their ass jumped.
Okay.
But nah, Broly hit him with that Uno reverse card, bruh. He said y'all niggas about to get jumped by me and me alone, bitch. I mean, y'all, look at this. Look at this.
He ain't even phasing
the
him.
Disrespect.
Got his arms folded.
Right?
He didn't even move from the spot.
He said that's all y'all got.
Look at he didn't move from that spot.
He came in trying to attack Broly. Nah, he ended up hurting himself from trying to attack him.
Broly said,
look at this. This man is moving like a damn freight train. Imagine you are in a dark alley and then you see this shit coming at your ass. Look how he just kicks Piccolo out the way, bruh.
Gave him the backhand a lot of times.
Backhand, that was a kick.
Was just roadkill on the road, and Broly just
as hard as he kicked him,
over.
Was like a backhand.
There go Vegeta again.
How the
looking
pimps do
like
in the movies?
A bitch. This man really had to pick his sorry ass up. And
yeah, that's how they do
it
in the movies.
All the way out
like
here,
you just
right?
did.
Pressing my motherfucking buttons, my nigga. You know, acting like a bitch. You supposed to be the hardest nigga in the Z Fighters, bro. And you out here getting caught lacking. Like, this man Piccolo had to give him a whole ass pep talk. And then this man Broly did the most savage thing I've ever seen in my life. He walked through a Kamehameha. Oh,
how
my
did you
God.
Walk through a
Not
Kamehameha?
Even a scratch in this nigga is laughing. Look at this man Goku's face, bro. This just says it all.
What the fuck is we doing?
So Vegeta finally grew up.
Seeing that chest on that nigga though, that's why he was able to walk through that.
We all know what was gonna happen.
One clothesline knocked him out of Super Saiyan.
At least he tried. That's all I'm gonna say. And then this man killed his pops. He crushed him in that small ass escape pod.
He
and
did.
Threw his ass to goddamn Narnia. Like, he chucked that bitch. Like, what is that Olympic sport where, like, they twirl around and, like, they chuck the fuck out of that ball? Discus. Yeah. Discus. He played discus with his pops as the goddamn ball. Nigga set a galactic record. And then he started jumping on this man like a damn
I don't
trampoline.
See how they still
oh
sitting there trying
Lord
to fight him. They should have just left.
Bro, do I
would have instant transmissioned off the planet.
Okay.
Yeah, that was Exhibit A. So I guess we'll do Exhibit B. I mean, he don't need it, but we'll do Exhibit B. So Exhibit B. This man came back from the brink of death to beat the shit out of Goku's kids and his daughter-in-law in a younger version of Trunks again. Oh my god. This shit gotta stop, bruh. Broly. I don't know what this man Goku
just
did to piss you off so much. I mean, was his crying that damn loud? Like, my nigga, you should have.
And in that movie,
noise complaint or something.
He wasn't
like,
even.
He
wasn't even legendary Super Saiyan, and he was still putting hands on them.
That's crazy.
Oh my gosh, bro! I felt so bad for Goku.
Gohan had to come
help.
This is why
you should never get the same haircut as your father. And then, oh, poor Trunks as well. Like, this man already beat up his future self, so he said, "You know what? I'm gonna beat up your present self now." Videl also got slaughtered, but I mean, at least it wasn't as bad as a Spokovich ass whooping.
Oh, Spokovich put hands
on. That is one of the most brutal beatdowns in anime history, hands down. Then Gohan had to get his ass whooped again.
Again.
He had PTSD after last time when he got his face dragged through the wall. Like, my my God, like, look at this. He is, like, bending his spine right now. Woo! Then he gave him the nastiest bear hug of all time.
Man, I know his back.
I love how
aching.
The only way they could beat this man.
He's like, my back!
Power.
My back!
Yeah, we're gonna need a bigger table. Cause this man has clearly earned his spot on the round table of Air Force activity. Like,
most
this
definitely.
Is savagery on another level. But I am not talking about Bio Broly. That movie
yeah,
was some ass.
Yeah, that boot.
Even
movie
though
was
Super
trash.
Broly is a way, way, way better written character than Z Broly just had that just savageness. That
yeah.
just ruthless ass aggression. Like, every time you saw this man on the screen, you knew somebody was about to get their ass bodied.
Man.
So, yeah, Broly is a menace. He made this table with ease. We only needed two exhibits. So, I mean, yeah, that's basically it.
Patrick,
I mean, if you see anybody running down the street or running down an alley looking like this, just do yourself a favor and just cover up your booty cheeks. So, I'm just going to go ahead
okay.
and skedaddle.
In my opinion, that man is diabolical.
I ain't gonna tell you what I would do if I seen somebody run down the alley like that.
That's
why
crazy.
Am I going down the alley at night, though?
That's what I'm saying.
I'm not even going down the alley during the daytime. Well, I'm lying. When we was in Chicago, I was always
ain't no
going
alleys
down
here,
alley.
Though. Ain't no alleys here.
Yeah.
It was in Chicago, but ain't no alleys
yeah,
here.
I'm talking about why am I going down the alley at night. We was younger. This all, we used to go through alleys
oh,
all
yeah,
the time.
Oh, yeah, I used to walk through the alley all the time when I was
at
a kid.
At night, during the daytime.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It was a shorter... It seemed like it made the distance when you walking somewhere like shorter going through the alleys instead of like on the side.
Yeah, and then when you was a kid, oh, in Chicago, most people don't even go through the front door. They go through the back door.
Yeah, literally.
Like, literally. I don't know what it is about back doors. Matter of fact, in Chicago, you know how most other places you'll go somewhere like, say, Iowa or Missouri, and most of the houses, got the driveway in the front.
Yeah.
It's in the back.
It was always in the back.
You
so,
go through the alley and you park behind
right.
your house and use the back door. It was
so,
literally, so that most people use the back door.
Yeah. So as soon as you got the car, you go straight through the back door, go on up in the house.
Yeah.
Like as a kid, we rarely used the front door. It was always the
oh,
back door.
Oh, my soul, go straight out the back door. Right through the alley, go around the house
yeah.
to the front instead of going out the front
you
door.
Know? Like, man, memories, man. Anyway,
oh my soul.
We
Mama, like,
y'all
go to the store
for
me. You don't go to the front, go through the front door where you can just shoot
right
down right. the street. You go right around, go through the alley, go right around, then go past the house.
Y'all have a blessed day, y'all. Peace.
Did B go off? Hey.